Gun Gods and Gun Goddesses. Welcome back to another episode of Gun Goddess TV. I am Gun Goddess 314. Happy New Year to you guys. I know it's been a while since I put out a video, but it's the first day of 2022, and I'm back on it. So in today's episode, I am here at the gun show. This is my first time coming to a gun show, so I've never been to one of these. I don't know what to expect. So let's go check it out. For those of you who've never been to a gun show like me, they do cost to get in. This particular gun show costs $14 to get in for adults. If you plan on going for the whole weekend, that one time payment is all you need, because when you leave, they give you a cooler wristband so that you can keep coming back and not have to keep paying the $14 or however many dollars it is. Now, it may not sound like it, but the gun show is actually a family event. You can bring your kids to the gun show. There's not just guns and weapons there. They have different things as well. I went with my dad, and he got me this really cool origami owl necklace. It's got interchangeable charms and everything. They have a variety of things for a variety of different people. I saw the pimped out pickles there. They have kids' toys. They have different vendors that sell different things. Coin collectors and things like that. So you don't just have to be into guns and knives just to go to the gun show. Now, they did have some really cool guns there, like the Chris Vector. I thought that was really cool. I was really surprised about that one. I found my next gun, the Springfield Hellcat. But for the most part, most of the booths were like price gouging really bad. I was really surprised when I looked at some of those prices. Shout out to Prime Protection STL. They are a black owned gun store that is not gonna take your money. So if you're looking for reasonably priced guns, I would suggest checking them out the next time you're at a gun show, or go check out their actual store. The gun show, they had some pretty decent, some pretty cool. I thought some very interesting custom guns. Other than that, if you guys are looking to buy an actual gun, overall, I would suggest going to an actual store or ordering it offline as opposed to going to a gun show. But if you are so determined to get a gun from a gun show, I would suggest you shop around. Don't buy the first gun from the first vendor that you see. That's gonna be all for this episode, guys. As always, peace, love, and happiness, and see you in the next episode.